I think everyone in Thailand and friends in the international community knows that the present constitution of the Kingdom of Thailand is not very democratic. One could say that it is a mixture of authoritarianism and liberalism. So for that matter, then we have an election system, and I think the running of government that is half authoritarian, half democratic. Or to say it generally, then the participation of the people in the political processes and the decision making is more or less limited. We are a representative democracy, but not yet a consultative and participatory democracy. And to do that, we have to have a new constitution or to amend the constitution drastically to, I think, do more of the decentralization, delegation of power to the professional association, to the localities, and so on. More or less decentralization of the, I think, the governmental or administrative setup, and allow more of the voices from the interest group, like the farm groups, the labor professionals of all kinds, and so on, for people to be able to express, to participate, and to join in the decision making. And I think this present government under General Prayut Chan-o-cha has been in power under the present constitution for more than 2 years. But it was understood from the very beginning that this present coalition government would undertake to do the amendments of the constitution to move democracy forward, or to discuss elements of authoritarianism from the legal instrument of Thailand, the constitution, as well as to get rid of all the authoritarian practices, as well including the involvement of bureaucracy, especially the military, in the political life of Thailand. Because in the upper house, the Senate, there are 6 serving generals, you know, bureaucrats, who have become senators. So they are having the dual roles. On one hand, they are bureaucrats, civil servants. On the other hand, they are politicians, because they are in the Senate, part of the parliament of Thailand. And then there have been so much talks about amending the constitution to make it more democratic, to make Thailand more participatory and decentralized. And at the same time, I think people of all walks of life have submitted their signature together to send that people's draft constitution to the parliament. The second time was only a few weeks ago. I did also, I think, affix my signature to that draft. The draft was being signed by 130,000 people. 130,000 people. Then when it got to the parliament, after I think a few days of deliberation by parliamentarians and so on of both houses, it was more or less discarded, kicked out. What it meant is that 750 members of the Thai parliament, both the upper and the lower house, had not heeded to the voices and wishes of 130,000 people, which among these 130,000 people, I'm quite sure that it reflects people of all walks of life of the Thai society. So the voices of the majority of the ordinary people have not been taken into account seriously by the members of the parliament. With that, then I can say that the parliamentarians, together with other members of the government and bureaucracy, are also, they are part of the elitist establishment, and they are conservative in nature, in that they would like to keep everything as a status quo. No change, no amendment. Let's go along with things as they are. Namely, let's live with this undemocratic constitutional of Thailand and have a democratic system that is half authoritarian. And, you know, lack of accountability, check and balance, and so on. And I think a sort of a top-down way of doing things. decision by the cabinet, decision by the majority of the votes in the parliament, but not much of the consultative and participatory process on behalf of the people. So in that sense, I see the current situation of Thailand as the entrenchment of the conservative side, or conservatism, I think, cast their dark shadows over the political life of Thailand. Even some of the political parties that were being perceived to be more liberal and democratic, especially the Democrat Party of Thailand, which I used to a member at one time, has joined the coalition and have joined, I think, the establishment in denying the draft constitution of the people of 130,000 altogether. So in that sense, one could also say that people or the public in general cannot rely on Thai political parties, because it could be said that 90% of Thai political parties and politicians are members of the elitist, of the establishment, the status quo holder. People who are afraid of change, people who are afraid of more democracy in the Thai life and Thai political process. See, but in that, and that is one of the reasons why last week President Biden of the United States has sent invitations to about 100 countries, half of the total number of countries of the world, inviting them to join in his, I think, organized conference on democracy. It will be held on the 9th of December online. And surprisingly or not surprisingly, Thailand, a great non-NATO ally of the United States, security ally of the United States, has not been invited. Because Thailand, from the perception of the United States and many of the democracies around the world, near and far, deem Thailand to be an undemocratic country. Although we do have elections, you know, for the parliamentary seats and so on, but that's only one aspect of democracy. But the other aspect of democracy, of consultation, participation, you know, referendum, public hearing, town hall meeting, all of this and so on, are not extensively or seriously practiced in the Thai kingdom by the Thai government and so on. So maybe the Thai government under General Prayut doesn't care, because they are not democratic anyway. So they do not care about Thailand not being invited by President Biden. But myself, and as many of my friends and my colleagues and also on, and all the Thai people that I do not know, but I'm quite sure that they are liberal, they are democratic, and they are progressive. I think we all of us must have felt ashamed that Thailand is not a democracy, that Thailand partial democracy is not even recognized, that we do not belong to the, I think, the democracy club of the world. This is unacceptable, I think, to the Thai people that profess themselves to be the lovers of freedom, of liberty and fraternity and all of this and so on. So it is incumbent upon the Thai people, especially the progressive force, to keep on pushing, you know, authoritarianism in Thailand away and reintroduce liberal democracy, participatory politics, and to keep on pushing, pressing political parties and I think such governments, you know, the present and the future and so on, to change their mind, change their attitude and become democratic. Because the more that they become entrenched status quo holder, conservative in their thinking mentality and in the practice of running the government, it will split the Thai society further, and there will be more confrontation that one could not, I think, prevent violence if it were to happen, unless and until there is more dialogue among all the stakeholders of Thailand, and hopefully that the elite established authorities of Thailand will take, I think, happenings around the world into account. The latest is the protest in Sudan the fact that I think most of the Sudanese people do not want to see any more coup d'etat, military government, and authoritarian regime. People are fighting for democracy, sacrificing their life, and I don't think Thai people are immune to this or foreign to this. We have gone through many processes of fighting for our belief for liberal democracy. And if we are going to be more connected, there is no guarantee that we will come out again. But hopefully that I think the establishment under the leadership of General Prayut Chan-o-cha, the Prime Minister, will heed our call and use his good conscience to turn around and work for the democratic advancement of Thailand. Thank you very much. ขอบคุณครับ